Hey, this is just another way that Dr. Dita and I can stay in touch and keep you all abreast of what's going on in the whole process of this miraculous move of God in my life and even in the life of the ministry. Because you all are very, very much a part of this whole process.
Amen.
You had to stand as well as we had to stand with respect to this whole episode. Mm-hmm. And we're grateful to God for your standing, your knowing how to stand, and your being committed to stand. It takes great commitment to stand with anything or anyone, especially when adversity hits.
I agree.
And this ministry has been tested. And ladies and gentlemen, we have passed the test with flying colors.
But Pastor Mike, I wanted to say this, you know, the way that we have all been sticking together and the commitment that you all have been demonstrating really is a true testimony of the great leadership that we all have had. We have a pastor that knows how to lead the flock and care for the flock, and you guys have been just awesome in, you know, just hanging in there and just believing God with us. Now is not the time to back off in your prayers and in your faith. Keep applying your faith to this situation.
Right.
Don't just stop now. You know, be a marathon runner with us and continue to believe God with us. Everything is going great, but just like the scripture
says, there's still some things that we have to continue
exactly,
to believe God for.
Exactly. Right. And the scripture is so, like Nahum 1:9, it says that God has put an other end to what has gone on in his body, and we believe that.
Absolutely.
But we decree that this thing will not rise up a second time.
Absolutely.
So keep praying with us, keep standing with us. Don't back off now. Every day you thank God.
Absolutely.
For the continuation of his health and that his body will operate at its optimum level of function. In Jesus' name. Amen.
Yeah, and whatever you are believing God for, this should encourage you that he is indeed who he say he happens to be. He is Jehovah Rapha. He's the healer, our God, and our God is God. Ladies and gentlemen, emphatically, we win without a shadow of a doubt.
Yes,
I was reading today over in John 11 where Jesus returned when he got word that Lazarus had died. And Mary walked up to him and said, I know that God will do whatever you ask him. Mm. And that confidence in us knowing that we are co-heirs with Jesus, mm-hmm. then God will also have to do whatever we ask him.
That would demonstrate that, because if Mary said that about God would do whatever Jesus asked him, she had to believe that Jesus would do exactly what she asked him to do.
Absolutely. And therefore, you all can do the same. Anything that you're believing God, we done got into preaching.
This is good. This is
anything
good.
That you're believing God for, we stand right now for your immediate request being fulfilled and answer being given. Hey, I failed to mention this new chick that I got here all this hair. I guess somebody should say something.
Yeah, well,
it was
true.
Another
that's
miracle
true.
That took place.
Well, I couldn't let you be the only miracle.
One night she went to bed with no hair, and then she woke up with a bunch. God
somebody
is a miracle.
Somebody better hurry up and get me out of this place, because I'm telling you, I'm just doing some things in here.
So stay open. No, truly, stay open for miracles. God gave me that word, and I want you to receive that word with all readiness of mind. Stay encouraged. Romans 8:32 again says that if God did not spare his own son, how much more will he give us whatever we ask? And that's what we've been
saying. That's good. But I was just getting ready to say, it's like we are getting ready to see some miracles take place in our midst like never before. I mean, things have been prophesied over this man's life. I mean, just like the hands of oil robbers were laid on you and he, you know, brought forth through the, of course, the laying on of hands, the miracles and the healings that have taken place in so many people's lives. It's going to be the same way, you know, with your life, Pastor Mike. And so I'm looking forward to getting him back in his set place to do exactly what God has assigned to his hands to carry out. We don't have long. Man, the update is he is doing wonderful. We're believing God really next in a few days.
We'll be out of here.
We'll be out of here. So next week, we'll show you the video of him going to the car, getting out of this place because God is a healer. Awesome. We're about to take this man home. It's been 9 weeks away from home. Well, really, he only remember 4 of them, right? Because he was out the other days, but I remember all 9 weeks.
Okay, so.
I'm just missing you guys. Love you. Telling me don't stop
talking.
And she
could come to church. I don't know why she hasn't been to church.
Because he needs me. I'm being a wife.
Final word. Last update I gave you, I told you the medication had caused a change in my football team preference. Monday night, I want to report that the medication wore off, and I'm back in the socket. I'm back in place. Hail to the Redskins.
Hail to the Redskins.
Forgive me forever leaving. I'm coming back to you.
Pastor Dwayne said they lost because you were their Jonah.
Yeah, Pastor.
You were on the wrong ship.
Pastor Dwayne is having a hard time accepting it. But we had a good time on Monday night. Hey, listen, we're going to get out of here. We're going to see you real soon. Thanks again for staying committed. Thanks again for your continuous giving, your support, your attendance has been great, and we thank God for you. So, always remember, life is better when you're living by faith. See you soon.
Let me get busy.